Jian Cheng from High Silicon.
Hi. And who are you?
I'm Biao. I'm He Biao. Yes, I'm from High Silicon.
From High Silicon.
Yes.
And who are you?
CLT from Huawei.
Huawei. And who are you?
I'm Naresh Kamboju, Linux kernel validation engineer. I'm demonstrating this one setup. The question is,
this is the LKFT stuff?
It's a Linux kernel functional validation. We are validating the Linux kernels. So that's the way we are able to find the bugs and the report to the upstream. So this is a complete framework. I will explain you part by part. Let's say you have a problem, how do you validate your Linux kernel every day? Because there are a lot of patches are coming in every day, every hour, and every minute. So there is a framework to be in a place to validate the stuff.
So, and a lot of people are using this now.
Yes,
not
yes.
only Linaro.
Not only for Linaro. Linaro took initiative to create a framework and ensuring that the long-term stable kernels are validated every time. So there is a Greg Cage. So he's pushing the patches every week or twice a week, and whenever there is a commits happening on the stable RCs. Currently we have 4.4, 4.9, and 4.14 and 4.18 maintained by Greg. So whenever there is a new patch set is coming in, we have a build system in place, the Jenkins in place. Jenkins are validating the build test. So once the build test is getting through, so currently we are building for x86 and x86-64, ARM32 and ARM64. So these are the main architectures we are currently focusing on. The once ensuring that the build test is complete, we'll be doing a functional validation. Functional validation includes a boot test and functional test of LTP, kself test, and leap huge pages.
So what do you do with this?
You can come down here. So this is the architecture. I could explain you. Currently, we are maintaining kernel branches of 4.4, 4.9, and 4.14, and 4.18. These are LTS branches, long-term stable branches. Then followed by mainline and the next. This is a Jenkins. Jenkins will be taking care of build. We are configured to build ARM32, ARM64, x86-64, and ARM8086. This level is for build test. We are ensuring that build is not breaking. So if there is a break, we are able to find out the breakages and reporting back to the maintainers of that particular kernel and the subsystem. So once the build is done, currently we are using OpenEmbedded as a user space for a pre-building of LTP and kself test and leap-huge pages. We have 24 test jobs for each device, I could say. Lava is a framework which has a pool of devices. Currently, I could show that how many devices we have. So these are the list of devices you could see. Your IKEA, Juno, BeagleBoard, and x86-64 and 32 and QMU configured. This is a Dragon Board and BeagleBone Black. These are the number of test cases you could see, 20,000 test cases per kernel commit you could call it as, or per kernel RC releases.
So what is a test? Well, how do you do a test?
So you could see here, we have a kself test around 100 test cases. We have a LTP of 3,000 test cases and leap huge pages of 90. So these are proper functional test cases, I could say. So we have a bunch of 10 environments of device pools, and we are testing on those. That's the way we validate the every Linux kernel. And going back to the slide, so there is a squad in the place. Squad will ensure it will pull the results from the lava. Once we have a result from the lava, we will compare the previous and the current results. If we find new passes, new fails, so we go through the triage of the bugs, and we'll find out which kernel is causing the problem. Which kernel committee is causing the problem. We have a setup of the things to do a triage there, and we ensure that the functional test is happening there. And if there is a new failure, we'll go through the failure of the stack dump and the kernel trace logs and the test outputs and all. So we go through that output and we will find out which kernel commit ID is causing that problem. Accordingly, we'll report to that particular kernel commit author or the maintainer of that particular subsystem, hey, saying that this commit is causing the problems, you know. Could you revert the patch? Could you fix the patch, you know? And we'll be sending out through emails to the open mailing list, kernel mailing list or stable mailing list. Accordingly, the maintainers will come up and, you know, fix those issues. So we have a little turnaround time to do all this stuff with the 20,000 test cases and 10 devices in place. So that's the way we have been validating the Linux kernel in a functional format. So we hope we'll be optimizing the turnaround time, and we recently also we are able to found many bugs in terms of, you know, memory slabs and all. So that's the way we are able to find a couple of bugs and reporting them, and the maintainers of the particular subsystem are happy to get to know what happening there, and they are able to catch those bugs in a less turnaround time. So that's the way we have been doing. Glad I'm
so what do you do? What is your job?
My job is to ensuring that the system is in place and everything goes in smooth way, and I will be validating the reports from the squad, ensuring that what is the new failures are happening, and go through that, do git bisect whenever you find a new failure, and do a git bisect, search for the bad commit and get that bad commit and report to the maintainer and mailing list, and getting those reports back to the mailing list.
So that's it's very busy, right?
It's not easy, it's like maintaining.
It's very busy.
Yeah, busy. Yeah, it's very busy.
So you have the whole world is interested in this.
Yes.
Everybody who works for Linux.
We have six people of team who are responsible for build, boots, you know, and maintaining the lava and triaging the stuff and reporting the. So I will be involving into the report to the grade, bad or good. So I have to report.
And every company in the world who works for Linux is using this?
Not now, but most of the people nowadays, they are adapting this framework, and as well as they are also following it. We are able to see like new people are coming up and asking the questions and trying to incorporate those, I mean, the member boards into systems, or they're getting this.
Is this a successor of Lava, or is just an accumulation after Lava?
Lava is a subset, I could say, out of this framework, because it's have Lava is a device of pool, so it just validates the stuff on a given board. So testing is one part, but validating and comparing results, getting a report out of it is pretty time-consuming stuff, I could say. So I could take you here. So let's say like, you have a KSL test, and you have a net underscore BIF through test.sh is one of the test cases from KSL test. So I would like to go through the test history of this test case. So how the test case is behaving on multiple trees, Linux mainline, Linux next, and the stable 4.14, 4.18, and 4.4 and 4.9. So I have a new, I have a dashboard kind of stuff here. This dashboard will show you on the Linux mainline, it's green, means like it's getting passed. So let's move on to the next. So there are still violation is happening there because there is no results because of same N, but there are few jobs are finished already, you could say like pass. If you go down, this test case is getting failed on 4.14. We have a reason because this is a new test case which is supposed to work on the 4.18 and above. That's why we could see like 4.18 is working, but 4.14 is not working, because the test cases is intended to work on the latest and the greatest trees. So the test case has to be, or the related patches has to be backported.
So, and is it just automatic? You can test if it's working, it's just automatic?
Most of the cases are automatic, but when we have to do a triage, why it not pass on the old kernels, why it's failing on the new kernels, you know? You have to do a comparison thing, you have to go through the kernel stack dump and the kernel crash logs and do a git bisect. So these are all we are doing, like it's a automation versus manual efforts. So we cannot do everything in the automation, because it may send out a false positive report also. So that's the way we get a git and ensuring that we are not sending out the false reports out. So we're ensuring that what happening there with our sign, only we are sending out the reports to Linux mailing list.